Welcome to Strider Trees. Today we're going to be talking about canopy anchors, and I'm here with Meg from Upward Training, and we're sponsored today by Edelrid North America, which is a fantastic brand that produces top-level gear, and I will tell you more about that later. But today we're talking about canopy anchors. This is the intro, so Meg, can you tell me what is a canopy anchor and why they're so critical for what we do in the trees?
Yeah, so canopy anchors is essentially the anchorage or the point that I'm going to be tying into as the climber that's going to be holding my life. And when I'm choosing a canopy anchor, I'm kind of thinking about what my scope of work is, what type of rope angles I'm going to be applying to the anchor, how much force it needs to withstand, and if it's going to be fit for purpose for what we're asking for it to deal with.
And like most things in the trees, what we do is essentially educated guessing. And rope access, obviously, you have engineered anchors. They know what they're gonna carry, they know what they're allowed to put on them. There's a huge safety factor. But out here in the trees, we don't have that luxury. So there's a whole art and a skill and some science even to deciding exactly where that anchor is gonna be, how strong it is, can I trust it, how much can I trust it, and how can I optimize an anchor that I've got that maybe I'm not happy with. So we're gonna cover all of that and more, hopefully a good long section about all the different types of gear that we use for canopy anchors in this series. So stay tuned, hopefully you'll enjoy and find it useful.
Hell yeah.
This video is brought to you by Edelrid. They're a German company that distributes here in North America, and I wanted to show you guys a couple of pieces of gear that I've been using for years that is the best in class. It's some of my favorite stuff. And so I want to share with you. Here we've got the Tree Rex saddle. This is my everyday climbing saddle. It's really lightweight, fully featured. It's got a spot for the transporter there. The gear loops are awesome. It's more breathable than anything else I've ever used and totally customizable. It's absolutely fantastic. They've also got these carabiners, which are among my favorite. They're triple lockers, and they've got this stainless steel insert. So it's a lightweight aluminum carabiner with the stainless steel insert for longer lasting durability. They make this awesome one that is a little more eco-friendly because it doesn't have to go through the treatment process. And it even has this little catch right here to keep your eye from sliding around, keep it oriented properly. And last but certainly not least are the Talon tree climbers. Obviously these are climbing gaffs, spikes, and they're the most comfortable ones on the market. They've got this big, breathable, thick cuff that is nice and ergonomically shaped for maximum comfort. Very adjustable, will fit any boot you put in it, and all of the Velcro and all the straps can be replaced separately. So it's a great piece of kit. They make fantastic gear. If you want to support me, support the channel, check them out in the link in the description. Now back to the action. The first thing to consider when starting or when coming out of a tree and trying to choose an anchor is, what's your access method? Are you comfortable with moving rope systems only? Are you comfortable with single rope systems only? Or are you familiar with both? And how do you choose? And what are the advantages of each? So we're gonna cover that a little bit here. I'm gonna assume you know the difference between a moving rope and a stationary rope system. We're gonna use the acronyms MRS and SRS or SRT to indicate those. If you're not familiar, check out the link in the description. I've got a video kind of just about that. But if moving rope system is your go-to, if that's what you're comfortable with, then my next question when I'm just trying to decide my anchorage is, how low are the initial branches? If the first branches on the tree are relatively low, then generally the fastest way into the tree is just to lob your line over and start getting in. One of the key advantages of a moving rope system is that I can actually advance it above me as I'm working my way up the tree, always maintaining at least one secure tie, and get myself all the way to the top before installing any sort of gear or hardware to make for a smoother, more efficient anchor. So generally, that's how I would approach a tree if I was going to be using a moving rope system. Now, a single rope system tends to be advantageous when things get a little bit taller. So Meg, what are some of the things that you would consider when you're looking at your anchor point for a single rope system?
So when I'm accessing a tree with a stationary rope system, my first consideration is, how easily can I isolate that branch union that I'm aiming for? And for all of us, we know that that, generally speaking, in the real world doesn't happen. It's not easy to isolate a branch. So my preferred method to access a tree is to set up a base anchor, because I don't have to isolate that branch, right? I can set up my base anchor, I can access all the way to the top, and then have someone remove my base anchor at the top. However, the consideration with that, with a base tie anchor, is that you're applying roughly 2 times the force to that branch union that you're shooting into. So if I'm going to be using that option, many times I'll make sure that it's redundant meaning that is to say that there's other branches that if this one gives out, where is my rope going to slide to next? So I always want to try to be redundant with a base anchor if I don't have the easily accessible way to isolate a branch and use a canopy anchor, because as we know, canopy anchors are generally only applying 1x the force.
So here we've got this relatively small tree, and I was able to just lob my rope up and over the bottom branch, and it's isolated. So that's something we were talking about. That's a major consideration for moving rope systems or single rope. And I like to make a quick and easy access. So a lot of times, if I'm gonna go moving rope, I'll isolate the branch. I'll use that canopy anchor for the moment. Once I climb up to it, I'll throw my lanyard around the tree. I'll disconnect this, I'll advance it above me, and I'll work my way to the top and install hardware. Now, trying to isolate a branch higher up matters more with a single rope system. And you're gonna explain the challenge there.
So when we're isolating in either a single rope or a moving rope system, the challenge is you're trying to get higher up into the tree. So the likelihood of you being able to take your throw ball and toss it up to your tie-in point that you've selected without encompassing any other branches is highly unlikely. So we're gonna take a step here, and I'm actually gonna throw into this tree to kind of showcase exactly what we're talking about as it pertains to isolating. Now, generally speaking, I wouldn't be throwing with my harness on, but here we are, you know, you work with what you got.
So what we can see here, we've got the throw ball, the throw weight, and this line.
Probably I could be able to isolate this.
But if you look up in the tree, there's a lot of branches in between where that rope is coming down. And she's manipulating that throw ball, trying to isolate the branch such that there are no branches in between either end of the line. So isolating a branch is a challenge because when you've got a lot of branches in the canopy, anytime you have branches in between me and my canopy anchor, if I'm using a moving rope system, then you have to work your way around them, which can be difficult. And if you're on a single rope system, then you won't be able to choke your tie point all the way up to the top, which may or may not be a problem depending on the forces involved. And we'll get more into that later. But I just want to show you guys a demonstration of what it means to isolate a branch if you aren't totally sure of it.
So as amazing as it would be to be able to set a canopy anchor from the ground every time, it's just unfortunately probably the most inefficient way as far as it pertains to time to access the tree. So my preferred method, again, is typically setting a basal anchor and optimizing forces as long as it's structurally sound enough to hold those forces, and then getting up to the top point and setting my canopy anchor once I'm in the tree, or if you're on a moving rope system like Josiah showcased earlier in the video, accessing low and then forwarding your system as you climb.
So just like in the nether tree, there's a whole bunch of different types of anchors, and I'm just going to run through them really quick here. The one I demonstrated over there is what we would call a natural crotch, or, you know, there's no friction saver involved, a natural crotch moving rope anchor. Basically, you've got your rope, it goes up and over the branch, the limb, the spar, and I'm just rubbing rope on tree, which has the advantage of being quick and easy and having some extra friction, but it has the disadvantage of potentially damaging species that have thinner bark. It could also, that friction can be an advantage or a disadvantage depending on what climb technique you're using. It slows things down if you're using mechanical advantage or if you're using a foot ascender, but it can be a little bit advantageous if you're using the old school hip thrust method, which I hope most of you are not using. The next one that you will see fairly commonly is the sleeve, which we've got going here on a Blake's hitch system. There is a, they make leather sleeves. This one is actually a section of conduit. It's really nice. It's very simple. It's easy to retrieve. All you gotta do to retrieve it is to tie a little stopper knot in your rope and pull it through, and that system will come right out of the tree, which is pretty slick. It also reduces the friction quite a bit. And it's much nicer on the bark. They call that a sleeve type cambium saver. The next one I want to mention here is the ring and ring, another really popular device. You'll see a lot of these. This one that I have installed is not adjustable, but we make a few different sizes, or Edelrid makes a few different sizes. And it's got a big ring and a small ring. And so it actually is a retrievable anchor as well. Although retrieving these things can be a bit of a trick. But the advantage of it is that once again, I'm not rubbing on the bark and my rope is running between those two rings. So it's not going through a conduit. So I'm exposing my rope to less friction. I'm gonna be interacting with less friction and it's gonna make my ascent a little bit easier. The disadvantage, the primary disadvantage being that this is a little bit tricky to set from the ground. It doesn't always retrieve perfectly. So sometimes you end up having to go back up the tree to get it out. So it's a little bit more of a fancy device. This is one that if I'm gonna use it, I will generally set when I'm in the tree. Lastly, we've got some fancier pulley type moving rope system anchors. This one here is made by ART. It has some really cool features that I'll talk about on another video. But the cool thing is it gives me a relatively frictionless system to climb on, which is really smooth to use because my moving rope system actually runs through a very high efficiency pulley. This one's also retrievable, and it gives me the option of having a single rope access line in addition to my moving rope system from the same anchor. This one's also a little bit easier to isolate, and it's not as necessary to isolate. So there's a bunch of advantages of this type of system. The primary disadvantages, it's a little bit slow to set up, and man, is it pricey. So those are kind of the general categories. There's pulley type systems like this, like the Teufelberger Pulley Saver, like the ART Rope Guide, or the Petzl Eject. Then we've got sleeve type cambium savers, and we've got ring and ring type cambium savers. And then there's the old natural crotch.
So Josiah just talked about some canopy anchors for moving rope system, and we're going to talk about some canopy anchors for stationary rope system now. The first one we have is a choking canopy anchor with an adjustable friction saver, similar to what he was using on the ring-to-ring, but it is adjustable, and that's mainly for spar work or working around different size branches. And what we did here is we passed our rope through, and then we tied some sort of midline attachment hitch, and then we spiked it with a carabiner for redundancy. If somehow this knot was able to go through that ring, this carabiner can't, so this is a really great option. I do use this quite a bit, but it is a little bit gear intensive. One of the pros of this as well is that we're only seeing one times the load at our tie-in point. So if we move over here, if we don't want to use gear, we want to keep it a simple option. If you're trying to be cost effective, you can see there's no gear needed here. All we did was do, this is an alpine butterfly, but you can use a running bowline or circus bowline, some sort of midline attachment hitch. And then you run the tail your end through the eye. And then all you have to do now is pull that all the way up and this chokes onto the branch union. So now I can climb the stationary rope here and then retrieve it by pulling it opposite on the line. Again, same as before, we're only seeing one times the load at the top tie-in point here, which is a benefit. A con, as you can see, is you have a lot of friction, especially on this eye and this system, and which can obviously cause abrasion and damage to the rope over time. So if we wanted to remove that, we could add more gear into it or just use a different method. And what we're gonna do now is we're going to talk about our basal anchor, which is kind of my go-to. Here you can see that we have one end tied off to the base of the tree with our safety little rescue knot here, which is just an alpine butterfly. Then it's up over the branch, and typically in a situation it's going to be going up over many branches, and then it comes back down to me and I climb the stationary part here. Now the thing to keep in mind at this point is that our tie-in point where our rope is going over the branch union is seeing about just under two times the load of what we're applying it to, which is neither good or bad per se, but it is something to keep in mind when you're choosing that tie-in point. Just make sure that it's fit for purpose and it can handle that load.
So thanks for joining us. Hopefully you found that useful. We just kind of covered the basics of canopy anchors, and there's a lot more to come. Next week, we will be diving into how to optimize for the load, whether you're using a moving rope system or a stationary rope system. So join us next week. Thank you.
Thanks, guys.